Not sure if you know much about how fruit and vegetable type foods get to your table, but FYI, dirt and farms are involved. And nothing symbolizes the farm like the tractor, that majestic machine with the huge wheels on the back and the fun-sized wheels on the front. Throughout history, the trusty tractor has been the way to plow in order to bring us our chow. These vast stretches of fertile farmland were plowed, tilled, and planted by farmers using a machine called a tractor, a motor-driven vehicle with large, heavy treads that can also pull other farm implements.
There really are what they call three power revolutions in agriculture. One of them was mid-19th century when they began to replace human labor with animal power. The next one is the tractor, so specifically the internal combustion engine tractor. But the tractor is the major power revolution in the 20th century.
The Henry Ford's Curator of Agriculture and the Environment, Debra Reid, met me in the museum's Greenfield Village to talk about the evolution of modern-day farm equipment.
When do we see the first tractors?
Steam traction engines. So the idea of a fuel like coal generating pressure to move a machine of its own accord, that's a tractor.
I had no idea that tractors were ever powered by steam.
Yes.
When do we see the first commercially popular tractor?
Oh, 1914 or so. A corporation by the name of ALLIS CHALMERS. It had an internal combustion engine, for one thing. It had a unicorn hitch, so there was a tight turning radius at the ends of fields.
Henry Ford was a farm kid.
Yes.
Does he get involved?
He does. He works for a decade with experimental tractors to put together a lightweight and more affordable tractor. He collaborates with his son, Edsel.
With Edsel?
Yes. He calls his company Ford and Son and create the Fordson.
The Fordson tractor was a smashing success, since a new one cost only $750. After selling 600,000 tractors worldwide, Ford abruptly left the tractor business in 1928. But a decade later, he met Irish engineer Harry Ferguson, who invented a mechanical three-point hitch device to lift the implements attached to tractors up and out of the ground, saving farmers from having to do it by hand. Ferguson demonstrated his innovation for Henry Ford. The two shook hands and became partners.
So the three-point hitch is quite literally three points.
One, two, three.
Yes. It helped keep the machinery in the ground.
This tractor was built in what year?
1955.
1955. And is it still in use today?
This one is still in use.
This one?
It here, yes. Groundster uses it.
After a little instruction, I was off to live my own Green Acres dream.
All right, we're plowing now.